Al-Bukhari was a master deceiver. Al-Bukhari was the ultimate censorship machine. Al-Bukhari was an individual. Part of the reason why he is so highly regarded by the Sunni scholarly community is because he was able to, what's the word they use? To redact all of these references and remove as many of those parts that would serve the Shia case, right? He did that, and there is so much evidence for that. One of which is the fact that even though Bukhari came about two generations after Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq alayhi salam, there's not a single hadith quoted by Imam al-Sadiq in Bukhari's book. Now you're talking about a book with what, 7,000-8,000 ahadith, and not a single one from Imam al-Sadiq? Imam al-Sadiq would, you know, 4,000 students studying under him. Imam al-Sadiq, who was the teacher of pretty much all of the Sunni leaders of the sect. And so for you to eliminate Imam al-Sadiq from the equation, the only one from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, the heir, the successor, the inheritor of all of this knowledge, what does that tell you about him? And the fact that he then quotes someone else who used to praise Ibn Muljam, the killer of Ali ibn Abi Talib. So I think there's no question that Bukhari was a master slicer, cutter, and censorer, right? That's something to keep in mind as we go along.